वेलकम टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल 24/7 एपी लाइब्रेरी. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अनदर इंग्लिश ग्रामर टॉपिक, डायरेक्ट इंडायरेक्ट स्पीच. इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट डायरेक्ट एंड इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच. Direct speech and indirect speech are the two ways of reporting what somebody said. Like, we have two sentences on this screen. One is of direct speech and one is of indirect speech. Direct speech, Manpreet said, "I am learning a new topic." In indirect speech, Manpreet said that she was learning a new topic. Here we can see the clear difference between the direct and indirect speech. Let's discuss the difference between these two, direct speech and indirect speech. First, direct speech. Quoting the exact word of the speaker is called direct speech. It includes the speaker with reporting verb and followed by the exact words which are enclosed in quotation marks, that is inverted commas, like you are seeing on the screen. For example, he said to me, "I am a teacher." Here we have he, speaker, next reporting verb, and the quoted words of the speaker, same as without any change, and that too in inverted commas, in quotation marks. Indirect speech. In indirect speech, we report what a speaker said but without quoting his or her exact words. It includes reported statement and the subordinator, like that we use in most of the sentences, and some others are also there which we will discuss in this video. To link the reported statement with the reporting verb, in indirect speech we use reported statement along with the subordinate to link the reported statement to the reporting verb. For example, he told me that he was a teacher. This is the sentence of indirect speech. The quoted speech undergoes some changes when it is changed from direct speech to indirect speech or indirect speech to direct speech. Then we have to do some changes in reporting verb and reported also. The first is the change of first person, second person and third person of pronouns. About pronouns, we have discussed in this video for which you are seeing a screen on this page. For the detailed information of pronouns, you can watch this video. The link has been shared in the description of this video. First is first person. First person we change according to the subject. Second person we change according to the object. And third person we don't change. Like two sentences are given on this screen. He said to me, "I am a teacher." And in indirect speech, he told me that he was a teacher. Here in first sentence we have I, but in second sentence we have used he. I is first person. We have changed it according to he, that is subject in this sentence. So according to subject, if we change I according to he, then we use he in indirect speech. He told me that he was a teacher. When the reporting verb is in the present tense, like says, word is there, or in the future tense, like will say word, will be there, the tense of the verb inside the quoted words remains unchanged in the indirect speech. For example, a sentence has been given on the screen, direct speech, he says, I am happy. In indirect speech, he says that he is happy. Here, we have not changed the tense of the sentence of quoted words. But on the other side, when the reporting verb is in the past tense, said, the tense of the verb inside the quoted words will change in the indirect speech. For example, same sentence we have in past, in direct speech we have he said I am happy. In indirect speech he said that he was happy. Here we have changed the tense of the sentence. So let's see some more changes. Tense wise changes. When we change any sentence of direct speech into indirect speech, then we change these tenses. All the present tenses we change into past tense, like simple present into simple past, present continuous into past continuous, present perfect, past perfect, and present perfect continues into past perfect continues. But simple past tense we change into past perfect tense. When we change any sentence of simple past tense of direct speech into indirect speech, then we change that tense into past perfect tense. And if we have a past continuous tense in direct speech, then we use a past perfect continuous tense in indirect speech. Some other words for which we use past form of these words: if in direct speech we have can, then we use could in indirect speech. Same may to, might, will, shall to, would, is, am, are to, was, were, has, have to, had, do, does, do, did. Let's see some other important changes. Today to that day, tonight to that night, now to then, ago to before, yesterday the previous day, last night the previous night, tomorrow the next day, next year the following year, here to there, come to go, this to that, and these to those. These are some words which we change when we change any sentence from direct speech to indirect speech. Let's see some changes which we do according to the kind of sentences. In assertive sentences, we use told in place of said to, and that in place of inverted commas. For example, we have a sentence on the screen. Megha said to her father, Nina has broken the glass. When we change this sentence into indirect speech, then we use told in place of said to and that in place of inverted commas, and the sentence will be, Megha told her father that Nina had broken the glass. And here we have present perfect tense in quoted words, in direct speech and we have changed it into past perfect tense. Next kind is interrogative sentences. Here we use asked in place of said to, and in place of inverted commas we use if or no word. Here we have two kinds of interrogative sentences. First is by using the helping verb at the starting. The sentence is, he said to his friend, "Have you taken my notebook?" The sentence in indirect speech will be, he asked his friend if he had taken his notebook. Here we have used asked in place of said to and if in place of inverted commas or as a subordinator. The second sentence that we have with W family word. The sentence is, he said to his friend, "Who has taken my notebook?" In indirect speech, the sentence will be like this. He asked his friend who had taken his notebook. Here we use asked in place of said to, and no subordinator has been used in this sentence. So, imperative sentences. In imperative sentences, we use requested, ordered, advised, suggested, warned in place of said to, and to in place of inverted commas as a subordinator. The sentence which we have as an example, Ravi said to him, "Complete your assignment." In indirect speech, the sentence will be, Ravi advised him to complete his assignment. Here we have used advised in place of said to and to as a subordinator. Here we have another example of imperative sentences in negative form. The detective said to the thief, "Don't move." In indirect speech, the sentence will be like this. The detective warned the thief not to move. Here we have used warned in place of said to, and not we have used before to. In these type of sentences, in negative imperative sentences, we use not before the subordinator to. Sentences with let us. In these type of sentences, we use proposed or suggested in place of said to, that as a subordinator, and we should in place of let us. For example, we have sentence here on the screen. Jack said to me, "Let's go for a vacation to the hills." When we change this sentence into indirect speech, the sentence will be, Jack suggested me that we should go for a vacation to the hills. Here we have used suggested in place of said to. The subordinate is that here, and we should in place of let us. Next and the last kind is exclamatory sentences. In exclamatory sentences, we use exclaimed with wonder, joy, or sorrow in place of said to, and that as a subordinator. We use wonder in those sentences where we have what and how in direct speech. Joy, when we have a hooray word in direct speech. And sorrow, when we have a alas in direct speech. Or any other words can be there to show the joy or to show sorrow, then we will use accordingly. Like here, we have the sentence, the captain said, "Hooray, we have won the match." In indirect speech, the captain exclaimed with joy that they had won the match. And when we have what or how in direct speech sentences, then we change in this way, which you are seeing on this screen. Sentences, he said, "What a pleasant surprise." In indirect speech, the sentence will be, he exclaimed with wonder that it was a pleasant surprise. Here, we have used exclaimed with wonder in place of said or said to, that as a subordinator, and after that, we have exclamatory sentence in direct speech. But here, in indirect speech, we will change it into simple sentence. So this was all about the direct and indirect speech. In next videos on our channel, we will discuss some other grammar topics. Stay tuned to our channel and subscribe our channel for more videos. Thank you.